Yeah, you slave us, I'm in pain. Yet you put a whip to my backside. You see that good ship, Jesus? Guess what? I'm glad it didn't capsize. You know why? On the inside, my people were on that side. Give me some water before I touch the outside. My brain is anti-clockwise. That's how I see them in the dark with my cat eyes. I left the church, so they said I backslide. They thought they got me on the day when I baptized. Life, my God is in top size. Every rain that falls.
So I have live inside the studio none other than King Fragrance, and you're listening to the music of King Fragrance. Well, I welcome you, King Fragrance, to Heart, Mind, and Soul to Soul.
Energy and vibration, mama. Every celestial day. We have celestial heights. Yeah, I want to say thanks to you and the family of RFM. I want to say thanks to all medium of the media. I want to say thanks to Jamaica, the mustard seed, the African pearl. I want to say thanks to the darkness, thanks to the light, and thanks to God Almighty, the universe. Energy.
Wonderful. You know, and that start to this interview kind of sets the level at which we're going to be operating on throughout the entire interview. It's a reason that we invited King Fragrance to be my guest. Whereas we really love achievement and we love people who are doing well, we also love people who can reason. Because you see, in a dem time, yeah, you know, we have to emancipate our mind.
Definitely.
And we have to set our mind in such a way, because it's a meditation war going right now.
Yes, spiritual warfare.
That's right. It's an heretical war going, which is spiritual war.
Yeah.
So we have to keep the reasoning at the highest level. And this is why I have invited someone like Fragrance. Now, I met you first as a songwriter.
Energy.
Right? And you were the new kid on the block, so to speak.
Definitely.
And at the time, we knew you as Fragrance. And we remember hearing about this new kid on the block, Fragrance, writing some good tune for some popular artist.
Yes, yes.
And that's how I first met you. You wrote this song for The Angel.
The Angel and the bugle and the Taurus rally never change. Nothing
right.
changed.
That's yeah. right.
Yeah.
So at the time, you were doing some writing for Sons of Spoon.
Sonny Spoon. General, big up yourself. Anyway, you're there. Sonny Spoon.
I see him, we respect you.
Yes.
All right. So that is how I first met you. So we have we talk all the time, I must say. But we talk more about life.
Life, yes.
As students of life.
Yeah, that's our purpose. That's why we are here.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So we're going to find out more now. I know a little bit more than perhaps a listener. So we're going to find out more about... tell me your name again.
Donald Keston King.
No, man. No, that name there, man. Me no have that name there.
Oh,
off, man.
Dale.
Die.
Yeah. Yeah. And if you observe the vibration and the name, you know, the EL is very necessary in our society, the L. So if you observe Daniel, L-I, some said Eli.
Gabriel.
Gabriel, Micah L.
Emmanuel. That's right.
Ezekiel.
Ellis.
Energy, vibration.
All right. Yeah. All right, beautiful. So we're going to find out more about you as a child. And we really, first of all, want to find out more about Wandy Bowlers. Now, when someone, even those of us born in Jamaica, hear the name Wandy Bowlers Mountain, the first question is, where in the world is that? Because enough people never know, say Wandy Bowlers, they're Jamaica.
All right. That mountain, Wandy Bowlers Mountain has so much power. It's not, that's Wandy Bowlers Mountain is a portal to Africa.
Right.
It's a gateway to the universe, Wandy Bowlers Mountain. And I'm from the community of Orange Brooks in Wandy Bowlers Mountain,
okay.
Divided into two districts, Connors and Friendship. And community, the energy that community brings, Jamaican people must be aware. Community states come. Unity.
Exactly.
So that's the vibrational frequency of community.
Right.
So in my community, you see unity. Connors and Friendship unite. So unity comes. So we no longer have to say community, we say unity.
Oh, vibration. Goodness. Nice. Yeah. Because unity come already.
Yeah.
Beautiful. All right. And then the other thing to, you know, fragrance is that one the bolas. Let's just talk about even the man one the bolas, because it's quite a history with even the name itself, one the bolas. You know, for those who don't know, one the bolas was the first chief
of the
Jamaican Maroons.
Yes, yes.
You know, and he was originally called one the Lubolo.
Definitely.
And them changed his name to Juan de Bolos. So, you know, Juan de Bolos was like the first Maroon chief. And the Spaniards used to use him to get rid of the English.
Yes.
And also to put on the manner some of the Maroon them with them considered to be rebellious.
Definitely.
And you know, say the same Maroon them ambush him and kill him.
Same Maroon.
yes. Because them say my sellout.
Yeah, you don't play with the black light.
No. True, man. Because them say my big sellout. So when the bolus, my darling, you don't know how
energy and vibration.
You don't know how your something go. Yeah. So them have him as a sellout. So them ambush him and kill him. So that's just a little bit of history of Juan de Bolas.
Yeah, and the people need to know their history.
And the people need to know. We need, you know what is beautiful about even doing this program? Everyone comes from somewhere. And most of the people, 99% of the people who we talk to come from right here. And it is just nice to just use the opportunity to enter into communities.
Yes.
And find out
more. And find out unity.
Yes, and find out.
You have to
unity.
Come. Yeah, you have to come into unity.
Exactly.
Yeah, energy.
Exactly. All right. So let us talk about fragrance now. And you were known as Dale.
Yes.
As a child.
Yes.
How were you raised in this Juan de Bolas community?
I raised on the level of acceptance. I won't even say was, because I am my family.
Right.
Yeah, and I was born to Iseline Garden and Vassal King. And we grew as a family. I have four brothers. I have a sister. You know, it was five brothers, but one went back into the unmanifested as a child.
Okay.
Yeah. So right now, this is my family virtue. You know, my family, I would class my family as the Incredibles.
Why?
Yeah. You know, the Incredibles. There is even a cartoon they call Incredibles. You know, my mother is the mother who knows how to make things stretch. You understand?
Yes.
Yeah. And my family is a sample family. And my family is, a lot of people see my family, but they don't know how we live.
Tell me why you call him a sample family.
Yeah, sample is like oneness. You know, that oneness in our family, we don't survive, we live.
I hear.
Because life is there to live. Life is not there to survive. Because everybody trying to survive, that is what causes competition. And if you are trying to survive, you're not going to find your true purpose. Because you're going to say, your purpose is not to be a taxi driver. And yet, because you want to survive, you go and you drive taxi.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not living life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And because of that now, there is competition.
Mm-hmm.
Because survival is what caused competition.
Mm-hmm.
And life wasn't created for competition. Mm-hmm. Life is here for oneness.
Absolutely. And competition caused bad mind.
Yes.
A true man. Okay, so you're from a family who did more than survive. You actually live together.
We live.
Yes, got that love.
Yeah, so there's no grudge in our family. Mm-hmm. We help each other. You know, brother, do this. If we're going to create a thing, we come together as a family and we create the thing. We don't break apart family. We create family.
So where do you fit into the five, into the four brothers, one sister?
I am the first for my father and the second for my mother.
Really?
Yeah.
So you're the first boy?
Yes.
For your dad?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, great. And then where the sister comes?
The sister... she's the first for my mother. So, you know, I'm the second for my mother.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and when we say, that still doesn't split the difference, because my sister is my full sister. There's no halfness to this thing.
We don't want to deal with the half.
Yeah, we don't deal with no half sister.
We don't deal with outside.
No, fragrance not the outside sister.
No, we don't deal with that something there.
Yeah.
That's something with them dash down power.
Yeah.
That's a colonial idiot thing. as Africans, we don't have no half or no outside.
Vibration.
Yeah, straight up. Me love how you deal with that right away.
Energy. Celestial heights.
That's right. So you have a family.
Yeah.
Yes. And all are included in the family.
All.
Okay. All right. So tell us a little bit more now, more about your mom. You start talking about your mom. Say, boy, she's the kind of lady who can stretch things.
All right. Mama, let me tell about my mother now. You see, even if we are in the house and we have $1 million, the $1 million cannot do what mommy do with $1.
Mm-hmm. I hear you.
Yeah. Mommy, whenever fragrance cook, at times I have to say, oh, mommy, do it. Because whenever I cook, even if I buy any amount of food, it still seems as if it's short. You know, and my mother, we use $1 and create the nicest meal, create the nicest things. And yet, anybody comes into my house, in my home, let me say home, anybody come into my home, my mother feed everybody.
With the dollar.
With the dollar.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that is the power of God.
That
Almighty.
Is, yes, that is our love.
Yeah.
I love the them thing there, yeah. You know. Remember, you know, the feeding of the 5,000, I love that, you know.
Yeah, you find the right thing. That is what, that's the same thing Christ speak about.
Absolutely.
So, and remember Christ speak in parables.
Yes.
So people don't understand Christ. When I use Christ, I don't use Christ as cliche. I use Christ because I am the I am that I am.
And you're overs.
And I overs.
Who was Christ? Who is Christ?
Yes, and the Christ is still within.
Absolutely.
It's within me. It's within you. It's within everyone.
Absolutely.
So, Jamaica, wake up.
So, we love that. So, mommy was the real loving kind of mom who could create miracles in our family. Because basically, that you're telling me.
Definitely.
All right, tell me about your dad now.
Well, my dad, no. My dad is a warrior, is a Rasta.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, my dad is a Rasta and he's a farmer.
Right.
And my dad still take care of everybody in the family. Whenever he works, he just works for us. At times I say, hey, you don't have to kill out yourself and all that. He's saying, you can't do it, just they have to do what I do. So, at them vibration, the mama.
Yeah.
So, in my family, we have Rasta in my family. Like fragrance now, personally, I am not a part of any specific religion because I find God in every religion. I can go where the Muslims at and find God. I can go where the Christians at and find God. And I can go anywhere and find God because I know God.
We're going to talk about that later. But thanks for bringing that up because we have to get into your spirituality. No way we can have because you have a very interesting way of manifesting your spirituality. All right. So dad now was a Rasta man and a farmer man. And what do you think was the biggest lesson you learned from your dad?
My dad teach me consistency. My dad teaches loyalty. My dad teaches me, you know, trust and kindness. Mm-mm. And all that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's my family. We are, at times we have our differences, but differences is what make us stronger.
Yes,
yeah,
so true.
Differences doesn't part us.
That's right.
You know?
All right. When I was reading your bio, it seemed to me like you're the kind of child who wanted to do many things. So make we go through the list.
Yeah.
Make we start with your desire at a very early age to be a soldier. Tell us about that desire, where it came from and why. Why did you want to be a soldier?
There's a warrior spirit within.
Yeah.
And when I left my previous cycle, I was a warrior.
Explain to those who are listening, because I like me mad enough to understand what you just say. But for those when there's some mad like we, explain what you mean when you say your previous cycle, you're a warrior.
Yes, because in life, there is the process of life is eternal. Life has no opposite. And the only definition of life is life. And the cycle of life is birth and death. So this is the process we go through continuously. And when you reach that process of death, that's where the judgment is. You decide how you're going to come back in life and all that. That's where, that's the judgment. So the process of death is not for anyone. That's why Christ said, no man know the minute are the hour. And that's what Christ teaches. But people misunderstood this. That is what Christ preaches when he said, no man know the minute or the hour. The only thing that prove and manifest that from eternity always is death.
So you're saying the process of life is life and death.
Birth and death. So death would be the opposite of birth, not the opposite of life.
So that means that if the process is birth and death, and it's an ever-living process, one can automatically assume that we have lived before and died before.
Yes, I've lived before. That's why a man would ask me if I've never been to Africa, how I do Africa like that. Of course, I am an African. In the slave ship, I told you I was there when the ship came.
Right.
So I know. Because the Almighty within me teaches me.
Right.
Not a man come before me and telling me his life. There's Almighty within me that teaches.
Okay, so that's why you want to be a soldier. Because yes. there's a spirit in you that was telling you from long time that in a time past,
yes,
you were a warrior.
Yes.
Got you loud and clear.
Definitely.
All right, let us talk about another one on the list. We don't reach music yet. This part fascinated me.
Yes.
You said that you are a big fan of the radio personality, Mikey Dread.
Yes.
Me dear sir, you think I your one.
Yeah. Mikey Dread.
Mikey Dread opened up a whole world on radio.
Yes.
And people need to really remember that. Rest his soul.
Yes.
But when the Dread at the control.
If you observe, that is the same thing in my song, Prostitute.
Yes, you know, yes.
Yeah, because I have to carry his spirit and let both spirit combine.
Tell me what it is about Mikey Dread that attracted you, and also tell me about his influence on you.
The thing about Mikey Dread as a youth, and to be frank, I didn't grow up listening to Mikey Dread, you know,
okay.
Even though he was the one who really bring me to this music, who really take out my energy as a child.
No, you're too young for grow up listening to Mikey Dread.
Yes. So he used to use all those talks and all them energy. I like his slangs and the way, you know, he just bring across his message to people and all that, you know. So Mikey Dread, you know, I give thanks to Mikey Dread, and from there he influences me like that. But to be serious, I can't sing to you a dozen Mikey Dread songs.
But when you're a child.
But I have to give thanks for his energy.
His energy.
So that is why I mention it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, fine. So
definitely.
Mikey Dread, rest your soul. I'm sure he's hearing us.
Yes.
Yeah, man. Unlike you, I grew up listening to him.
Yes.
And I know it's a very powerful energy. In fact, Mikey Dread wanted a program in the day, and they refused to have the dreadlocks in the day. So them give him a program way down in the graveyard shift, and Mikey Dread took that graveyard shift and turned it in a daylight.
Definitely.
So forever, Mikey Dread forever. All right. So let us go forward now to Wandy Bowlers, right? You're talking about Connors and which is the other community?
Friendship, but there's an adjoining community, Ginger Ridge.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you attended the Connors Basic School, and then later on, you attended the Ginger Ridge Arlene School.
Yes.
All right, let us talk school, because you know we have to do the school thing.
Yes.
What was your favorite subjects in the classroom?
History, agriculture, mathematics. Yeah.
And have you?
And art.
And art?
Yeah.
You know, you are very artistic. You're not just a singer, but even just the way you think.
Definitely.
You think as a free spirit, which is also one of the qualities of an artist. So you in the classroom, you're good at history, math. What about agriculture? Did you actually, the things that you learned in the classroom that you were good at, have you applied them in real life?
Yes, I have.
So you farm still?
Yeah, I haven't done any farming since recently, but I have farm.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, cool. All right, what about the subjects now? What about the your favorite extracurricular subjects, like, you know, what you did outside of the school? What were your favorites there?
Outside school, used to play sports and all that. You know that energy when you leave school and you play a little cricket and all that things, and all those things. And even though after that, you know, you're expecting to get some beating and all that because plate no wash and them things. You know the vibration and the whole energy, you know. So, well, I didn't do much out of school, more than
sports.
I have to say much in the Babylon world because since childhood, I'm a lover of nature. I just love to sit by myself. Easy. I don't really, even though everybody is my friend, I don't really sit in groups and discuss certain matters with friends. But I always have this energy. In my community, I'm not the one who people always see sitting on the street side and all that, but I am a friend with everyone. Not because I'm not there, they know.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So that's a vibration.
You're more in tune with nature.
Yes.
And every time we have conversations, fragrance, I mean, the kind of conversations that you have and the kind of love, it is almost as though you are in love. It's more than love. It's like you are in love with nature.
In love with love.
Yes, so you get dreamy there, so anyway, all right, so extracurricular activities, really, you're a nature lover.
Yes.
And as you say, you know, we need to set the bar a different way, because nothing in a Babylon the teacher say we can be a nature lover, but that no means that we can't be a nature lover and put it in our resume too, say we's a nature lover.
Yeah, that's why fragrance have so much nature.
No, moving right on. Elvis, you bring the cooker back and stick. You bring the belt.
Yeah, my mother always said my rude. You know that, my love. You know, my mother always said my rude.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
A rude career.
Definitely.
Okay, on that note, Tracy said, take a commercial break.
International control and show the world. Universal beat marshal, no partial. Play the boy selection, don't
but this is just a joke, not a little bit. Me went to bed with a prostitute. Don't work out the lady pregnant.
Very controversial artist. And you know, he's a man who just said a while ago that he's a lover of nature and that's why he got so much. Okay, right. So that's why I reached for that tune here, because I remember that one year too. Anyway, so you, as I said, it seems very clear to me that you had many interests growing up. We're talking about your love for history and agriculture and math. Also, that you're a sports person. You were also head boy and captain of the cricket team at Ginger Early School. Mm. Let me ask you this, though. Where and when did your writing skill and your musical ability, when did it begin to form?
My writing skill... all right, let me put the music ability now. At school, at Ginger Ridge, we always organize concerts. At that time, I used to do drama also, you know, acting and all that.
Obviously.
Yes, and at that time, when we keep concert, you know, fragrance is always freestyling. At that time, even to this point, I don't really write songs, you know. I'm always freestyling and all that and keep it in the memory because, you know, the chakras are open. Yeah, so at that time, I used to just go on stage and just sing about the teachers and spot and all that. And it created a vibration. I entertained the kids, my fellow students, during lunchtime and all that. You know, originally, the beating of Dex is the original thing for every artist.
Every youth.
Yes, so you know that that's it, the vibration. And that's where the connection comes from now. But writing now.
Mm-hmm.
When I was at Prospect College, you know, I used to have some friends, you know. They always write love letters, you know, and send to girls. Because Prospect College is just next door to us,
exactly,
right here.
Exactly where Prospect College is. We ask you about that too.
Yeah, so we normally write, they normally write love letters. And when they write love letters and all that, I used to read their love letters, you know, and all that, and fascinated by it too. And they used to listen even a lot of Celine Dion, and they put a lot of Celine Dion lyrics and all that in it. And silently fragrance writing his letters, you know, but I'm not giving them to any girls still, but just writing them and all that. And I realized that my style and the way I put my love letters and all that was totally different from theirs, because that's what is coming from within me, you know. Even though they were writing, they were depending they were dependent on other agencies.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
But I realized that this thing is within, you know. So I used to write, and I just write it just for the joy of me, you know. Yeah, for the inner being and all that, and just write it and store it. So that's where my writing ability really comes.
Okay. All right, let's talk about Prospect College now in St. Anne. I find it so interesting, right? This is the paramilitary institution that he attended. Now, I know exactly where Prospect is because I used to live near there at one stage. And when I used to pass there, I used to see the youngsters there. And time them come out another road and them have a poppy drive where they stop the car and sell the poppy them and that kind of thing.
Definitely.
And I always used to look at these young men and wonder, what is life like inside of that Prospect College? So let me ask you now, because I've never gotten a chance to ask any of the youngsters. You tell me about that institution and life within that institution.
Prospect College, it was formed by Harold Mitchell, and is an English. And Prospect College is a free institution.
It's free?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a free institution.
Mm-hmm.
And it only cares for 30 boys.
At a time?
Yeah. And 10 to each class.
Wow.
Yeah. So, you know, right there, the teacher, education is manageable.
Yes.
Because a teacher can only focus on 10 students.
Right.
More than 40 or 50.
Right, right. As a case, so
yes,
many times.
Yes. You know, and at Prospect now, we do a lot of agriculture.
Mm-hmm.
Farming. We sustain ourselves. Prospect teach us sustainability.
Okay.
That's Prospect College.
Right.
Prospect teach you how to that is why it's a paramilitary institution, because it teaches you how to live. You understand? It teaches you how to utilize the benefits of life.
Right.
Yeah, so
how to be self-sufficient.
Yes, yeah, so that's how outclass Prospect College, and it's a wonderful school.
Okay, so when I used to see the boys, I used to wonder, how did they get there? Were they transferred? Is it disciplinary problems that them did have why them reached there? How did you get there?
All right, how did I get to Prospect College now? A friend of mine told me about it. And I have to give thanks to Mr. Mackenzie, the principal at that moment, because he drive all the way from Ocherius to my school in St. Catherine to run exam for the boys, because my friend is the one who pulled that interest there, Glenroy Coleman,
mm-hmm.
You know? And when Mr. Mackenzie come and all that, and to see a man drive so far, you know, that's the energy, but he couldn't resist that energy because this is the work of God.
Yeah.
You understand? So if we have to jive go Africa, I mean have to jive car. Fragrance of a goddess.
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
He can't resist fragrance energy.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, he can't resist fragrance energy. You have to come for fragrance. This is fragrance.
If this is what was destined,
yes,
it had to happen.
Yes, this is what happened.
Exactly.
Yeah, this is what happened.
Exactly.
You know?
Yes.
And
yes.
So at the same time, I did exam and I had two choices, OSMRT and Prospect College. It isn't because of discipline why a young man would have to go to Prospect. It's just like any other high schools.
Okay.
Yeah.
But how difficult is it to get into, since they only have 30
students? It's very difficult because they run exams for many students all over the island.
Okay.
So you always have probably one from Montego Bay,
okay,
one from St. Catherine, probably even one from Ocherius here.
Got you.
Understand?
Got
you. So not every parish benefits Prospect College in 1 year.
I got you. You know, this is so interesting because I've always passed and looked at those boys and wondered, what is life at Prospect College like? So now I'm getting a first-hand thing. And you also mentioned that in that college, music, theory, and practical was compulsory.
Definitely.
So I'm sure that helped a lot on the journey.
Yes,
the
yes,
musical
yes,
journey.
Yes.
All right. While you were in your last year, I'm also thinking that part of you wanting to go to Prospect College was because you also wanted to be a soldier.
Yes, the Army.
The Army.
Yes,
but
yes.
What I found interesting is that in your last year at Prospect College, you decided to not go into the Army, but the Jamaica Constabulary Force. Talk about that.
The thing is that when I look, I'm a man who loves freedom, you know. And when I look and say, Army, No, I don't have me a camp too much, yeah, man. I mean, in them vibration. Now, yeah. Jamaican soldiers, them are will come like I just camp. They want to lie down in and sleep and all them things. I'm say, no. I say, I want free. I want police and home to my family. Oh. And all them energies come. I mean, this bandage thing, because fragrance is not a man of bunch. I love freedom, and freedom is a free expression of mind. So I have to just chat with freedom and know that this is fragrance.
But a lot of people listening would think that police are bandage. No?
Well, police couldn't be bandaged for fragrance. Probably bandaged for another
man.
Yes, but not for fragrance, because I know how to utilize the energy of freedom.
So what was it about Jamaica? Because, all right, fine, you don't want to go into the army, right? Because of the bandage, and I understand that. But what was it about the Jamaica Constabulary Force that interested you, apart from the freedom, over the army? Because there are other areas that you have to look upon too, with the police, in terms of safety and that kind of something there.
At the time, Mama, the energy, I would say it's the energy of the Almighty, because there's nothing really that attracts me. So probably I would say to have a job at the time.
Okay.
Probably just to have a job. It's not that, because even in the same year, a lot of young men were planning to go to the force, and that same year, a lot of police officers died. In 1999, they heard about how much gone for the year, and even my friends, some of my friends decided that they're not gonna bother to go to the police force. They're just gonna probably go to the army and all that, because too much man are in the force. Mm-hmm. But this energy, Mama, is the energy that of the Almighty, because I didn't know the purpose, but the Almighty does.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The I am within me knows, and I have to just be obedient to the God.
And the I am within you, that is where it was pointing you.
Yes, gotcha. Because it was the police force that my musical career really begins.
Can you believe that?
Yeah, it was in the police force. So this is how God works.
All right. It is now 12:59, and the I am within me is telling me, say, cash pad coming up anytime, you know. And you see, I know the China again, but trust me, still have to run with him. So, it is now time for us to join Dollars Pick 2, Pick 3, Pick 4.
Until there is first some black unity, we cannot think of being acceptable to others until we have first proven acceptable to ourselves.
Once again, we rejoin King Fragrance. That's our very special guest this afternoon on Heart, Mind, and Soul to Soul. Very interesting conversation we've been having so far. So when we left off, you were telling us that it was actually your time in the Jamaica Constabulary Force that motivated you to focus on the music. Tell us about that.
Definitely. When I was in the force, this freestyle energy comes up again. And I have a squad, Williams, you know, Sergeant Williams. He's Sergeant now.
Yeah.
He's stationed at Savlamar. Then I was in Negril. And he said, Fragrance. All right, let me give you the drama now. I was at a hotel.
Yeah.
And there was a white couple.
Right.
And I was freestyling some lyrics, you know.
Yeah.
And the couple was there, and I was... And the lyrics that I was sending out, you know, it gravitated to the female somehow, and the man somehow sight the energy, and he said, "Hey, come on, because this man is trying to take you over from me." Understand?
At you, him never know how you love nature. No, because him with a jar, we quicker. What happened, darling? Go ahead.
Insha makes you stay, man. At you run from nature. You know, and then Willie said to me, "Hey, you know, so what just happened? You have to take up music serious now." You know, and then the same time, I'm gonna show you the powers of the Almighty, you know, Mama. Same time, it was a spring break in Negril, and I think it was 2002, sometime thereabout. And when at the spring break, this is the power of the Almighty. At spring break, somehow a gentleman got arrested. And he was arrested for a spliff. And during that time at the station, he needed assistance. I was the one who assisted him, getting phone calls and all that. And he heard me. And he said, hey, you know, I know a good producer named Big B from Spanish Town. You know, I'm going to link up with him because I'm a good producer. And he give me the link. And through Beast now, I link with Rural. And that's the whole energy. That's the connection. That's how the power of God works. Nothing happened in life for any reason other than growth.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. That's a good story. So you see that? And also, it is so important for us to do good because through that, enough other things come to put us all. When and why did you get the name Fragrance?
Sunny Spoon.
A lie.
Yes, Sunny Spoon.
I name you Fragrance?
Yes, Sunny Spoon, because at that time, I used to sing with Essence, you know? And he said, hey, you know, say, you fi name Fragrance, because you bring Fragrance to the music.
Mm-mm.
And Sunny Spoon said, Fragrance, I just one thing want you do. Swing your floor. Work on your floor.
Mm-mm.
I'm listening to Sonny Spoon and go through and then me start work on my floor. And because I know the thing, you know, mama. So I am never in a rush for music. I am not hungry for music.
Right.
I am not hungry for what I am a part of.
Right, right, right.
So a lot of these artists, they have to just get rid of the hunger. The hunger for the thing. Because there is no hunger in music. Music is full with food.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's no hunger.
Very interesting, because I've never heard it put that way before. But if music is in you, you just need to just bring it out.
Bring it out.
Got you loud and clear. So that's how, you know, when I was writing the questions, right, and I was going and asking you about your name, right, I said, how you get this name? What I found interesting is that I know you as Fragrance, but then I realized that you don't name King already.
Definitely.
King is your father's name.
Yes, it's a royal energy, you know.
Nice energy.
Yeah, royal.
So you naturally name King.
Yeah, we're naturally King.
All right.
So we are moved from the kings through the line to Jesus Christ, to Selassie, them King David, all of them kings. So it's just the whole channel. So I am
King. Absolutely.
Yes.
All right, let us go soul to soul now, right? Make a switch part this then. Hold on a little bit now. First question for soul to soul. How has your paramilitary training and your work as an investigator in the Negril Criminal Investigation Branch prepared you for life generally?
As an investigator, that prepared me to investigate nature. Because I realized that it's not just a study, man. It's a study, the source man comes.
Mm-hmm.
So I get deeper into the source and I become acceptance. In order to understand or even overstand life, because it's a tool, life is a balance.
Mm-hmm.
So in order, I have growth as falling and rising. Some people only have growth as rising. In growth, I get my greatest strength in falling, when I have to let go of certain things and all that, and when you have nothing to work with, when you get to the nothingness of life, that's the energy from which everything comes.
It's almost like from light coming out of darkness.
Yes, it's the darkness and the light. I don't want anyone to come and just tell me about the light. When in the beginning, in the Bible, you see, they said, from the dark comes the light. So, and they're not teaching us about the darkness. There's power in the dark.
There is power in the dark. But let me ask you this, though. How was your mission investigating man? Why did it send you forward to nature? What was it about investigating man that sent you to nature?
In man, I realized that there was an imbalance. Man either want to do just good or bad. So, in man, there's an imbalance. And when I go to nature now, I want to know where's the balance. So, when I get my call, you know, mama, I got my call from the Almighty. And the call from the Almighty is like, hey, you, are you one of those hypocrites having a problem with God? And he said, you have a problem with how the world I run? me dumb to saying yes. I could only say no. I was dumb to saying yes. Because if you believe that God is running the world and God is in charge and you're saying the world is not running properly, that means you are saying God is not doing his job. So I realized that in life is the balance. So perfection is not just to do good and be there and talking him for good or just to do bad. God is perfect because God knows balance.
So would you say perfection is really
balance?
Real.
Yes.
It is balance. Perfection is balance. Absolutely fragrance. I know that is a bit difficult to wrap your head around it, but perfection is balance.
It's balance. Perfection is balance. It's perfection. Look, you couldn't be a police if there wasn't for crime. The fight against crime caused more crime. The fight against disease cause an epidemic of diseases. If you have a child and you fight that child and say, hey, you're just a bad boy, you're creating a more
dangerous
bad child.
Yes.
We have to learn acceptance. Unless you accept, you can unite. If we don't learn how to accept others, we can never unite. So we're talking about unity. Until we reach that point of acceptance, we can unite. So acceptance is what brings unity.
Very deep. Very deep. It's something that you're not going to just say, yeah, man, or no, sir. It's something that you have to think through.
Definitely.
Think through.
And acceptance doesn't mean that what the person do, you're going to do it. But you have to accept that Johnny is a thief.
Yes.
This is what Christ teaches, you know, and Emperor Selassie and all these people. This is what they preaches and teaches. Marcus, Mosiah, Garvey and all them. They learn how to accept. And from you accept, you will bring people together. How can you get a thief to come into your church if you're not going to accept him?
Absolutely. I agree 100%. Okay. You have subsequently left the police force and you're focusing now on music. What you mentioned your squad is, you did tell me what inspired the change. The fact that your squad is said that, but that yes. couldn't be enough because I know that you've always been in and out, you know, a love affair with the music. So what was the thing that inspired the change that you say, all right, a full force now me are going on music?
Okay then. I realized that once again, I have to give the Almighty credit.
Absolutely.
Yes, because I realized that everything I want to do, the energy, there's an energy that is pulling me from it. So if I say, hey, I'm going to work with this company, there's an energy to come and intervene and say, hey, you have to look. And at times I try other things and I say, the other thing that I try, it's not working, you know? And I just listen to that humble voice within, you know? And it's the same rebel voice. So not because we are humble, people think that we don't have rebel in us.
Balance again.
Balance. You understand? At time we choose to be shy. At time we chose to be brave. At time we choose to fight, you know? But as I said, when you fight, there is no winning.
It's like you're fighting yourself.
Yes, because when you fight, there's no winning. That is why the war is still on, because God is on both sides.
This is deep. This is deep. And when you say that, you say, because both sides are prayer, don't they?
Both sides are prayer. This man is praying to God, and we're not going to war. We no better stop fight. Yeah, stop fight.
Boy!
Fight against mm-mm. little Jamaica, the mustard seed, mm-mm. when you put it on paper. This is my place, and I saw your feeding zone. Energy.
Apart from the music, is there anything else that you're doing now? Any personal growth that you're experiencing now that perhaps would not have happened to Fragrance if you were still a member of the police force?
Apart from the music. Where am I now, Mama? This is where I'm at. I'm in present. And this is success for me. And where I'm at is music. And all I'm seeing now is music. And all I have in this world now is this family that is here. This is the present. So I practice present. I learn to stay in the now. Mm-hmm. To be fr- I can't tell you that tomorrow this is gonna happen.
I hear you.
Yeah, I take no thought of tomorrow. I live in the present. I just live now. Now is music, and now is success for me.
Right.
So this is the far. I'm preparing. So I'm prepared for the minute or the hour that no man knows. So everybody better get prepared.
You know, yes,
fragrance is prepared.
Interesting. Yes. All right. To date, what is the hardest lesson that you have had to learn?
The hardest lesson. I can't describe it as hardest because everything in life happens. And if I should walk down the street and probably lose a limb, it's the Almighty's way, you know?
Although,
and probably I lose that limb in order for me not to do another one, an energy that is of injustice.
I understand that. But we're human. We're all human. And although we're rising to a different level, we are always restricted by our humanness.
Yes.
And there are lessons in life that we all learn. Some of us find it so difficult that we postpone that lesson.
Okay. Not to look down on anyone.
Wow.
Not to look down on anyone. Don't give up.
Don't
discrimination, put that aside. Life. Everything is alive.
So you have had to learn that.
Yes.
Absolutely. Because there are some lessons, although it's natural in a life, it is difficult.
Yes.
Like, for example, forgiving your enemy. Anybody who says to me that forgiving your enemy is a breeze. Not being honest. That's a lesson that we have had to learn and is a difficult lesson.
Definitely.
And I understand what you just said a while ago, because there are some times when people would almost want you to look down upon them.
Definitely.
So you have had to learn not to do it.
Yes.
I hear you loud and clear.
Yes.
What is spirituality in your mind, and how do you manifest your spirituality?
Spirituality, I always try to find a meaning for spirituality. It always bring me to a point beyond meaning. Because spirituality is that divine energy that controls. It is that energy that is in everyone. That is the energy of life, spirituality. So it doesn't matter what you do, you're spiritual, even though you might not be aware, but you're spiritual, because spirituality is what brings the embodiment to do things. So spirituality, to put a definite meaning to spirituality, only thing I can say spirituality to me is life.
Mm-hmm. Which we all have.
Yes.
And once you have that, you are a spiritual.
Yes, and to know the inside, to know on your inside, enter heaven, enter the kingdom of God within you. Christ said, think not. He said, a man will come and say, lo, dear, look here. There's the kingdom. He said, believe not, because the kingdom of God is within you.
Absolutely. So very true.
Energy.
Wow.
Vibration.
Okay. Is there anything based on the journey? Because you're embarking on a very interesting journey. And like I said in the promo, I really know this to be a fact, that you're a brilliant student of life. And that's one of the greatest students you could have been. Is there anything based on this journey that you are going through, because you're still a relatively young man, is there anything in this journey of life that you are 100% sure about?
This journey?
Yes.
Of life?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Tell me what it is that you have learned, and you are one, you're not going to change your change, no growth not going to make you change. You're 100% sure about that something here.
I know God.
You sure about
it? Yes. I know God. I talk to God. I see God. I hear God.
And you sure him live?
God lives.
And what makes you so sure that you live?
The all, the universal law that governs. The all.
It is alive and well.
Yes, it's alive.
Yay! Lord of mercy. So the universe is alive and well.
It's alive and well.
And the laws are alive and well.
Yes, and it's the universal laws that govern. So anything you transmit, that's what come back to you. So it's the frequency you send. So if you treat me like a dog, probably in the next cycle you will come as a dog and I tie you with chain. I have you. So be careful how you treat people.
Say very careful how you treat people. Yeah. When you say you might come back barking.
Yeah, you might come back barking, you know. Energy.
Why? Yeah. All right. This is a quotation from a songwriter. And it says, the more we know about the score is the less we know about before. As we grow and learn, we sometimes have gracefully surrender some things that we have known.
Yes.
Along this process of having to let go of your opinions and beliefs, of any opinion or belief you have ever held, do you find it frightening to let go, or do you find it challenging, and why?
At times, it becomes challenging when you start thinking what people is gonna say, because even when I start growing my beard and all that, you know. You know, people start looking at you and say, oh.
Yeah,
turn
around.
Yeah, you know, you're not cute again and all them things, all them energies. And when you make all them vibrations, they come up on your mama. At times, you find it challenging because, you know, at times, you still, even though you want to please yourself, you want to please others.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so at times, those changes, because you're concerned about others so much, and because of that oneness that you have for others, you still would want to balance it and let them feel that way. But you have to come to that point in life where you have to realize that, hey, you have to live for yourself. You can't live like another man. If I want to be like Mama Elise, I already feel, because you come and you fulfill your purpose and I'm going to do the same thing like you. No, fragrance don't want to be like Bob Marley. Fragrance want to be fragrance, and I'm going to be fragrance.
Absolutely.
I don't want to be like Vibes Cartel. I am just fragrance.
Right.
So any other man see fragrance, that's fragrance. If you wanna know fragrance, listen to my music. You probably hear me sing about Africa now. Later when me and I dance, woman.
Yeah, I hear you.
Energy.
Because me know them thing.
Yes, and them vibration.
All right, fine. So let's say now you reach a stage like you just an example you just gave a while ago. And you're being very honest. Because as much as we say we don't care what people want, we say we do care.
No, we do care.
Yeah, we do care. And when you reach the stage now where, all right, you are an ex-police officer, seeing? You're accustomed to being groomed and shaved,
definitely.
Right? You're still very groomed, may I say, for those who not seeing you. So, but your hair growing. So you have this nice head of hair, which is very nicely groomed.
Thanks.
And you also have a heavy beard, not big and long, though. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, but
it is definitely heavier than we know.
Yes, and the way how I carry this is how because fragrance love cleanliness. That is within me. I'm not just gonna say, hey, because Johnny is a Rasta and them say Rasta not for use soap. Fragrance is not gonna use soap.
No, nobody does say Rasta not for use soap.
No, I said I'm just using the thing like some man would say that energy. You understand?
Right.
But fragrance is ever gonna please the inner being in him also, because this is what the inner being, this is, I probably at one point I say I'm gonna grow my locks, and then when I reach this stage in life I said, yeah, I love that look.
Yeah.
And this is where I'm at now.
Okay, good. I understand that very well. So the fragrance I used to say before was much more clean cut. You're still very clean, very, 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 very groomed, but you have more hair on your head and you have more hair on your face. When you get to the point where you're going to make a decision now to make that change, and you have people, loved ones who you care about, who perhaps don't want you to go in that direction, what it is about fragrance, what it is about your personality that helps you to move forward into who you want to be? And I'm asking you this question particularly because I know it is not easy for us to do. What is the attribute that you have inside of you that will make you say, you see, even although I love my girlfriend a whole lot and she prefer when me shave, me need to put on some hair upon my face?
Yes, mama, I had to make that decision, and I had to just make the decision and know that, guess what, I had to seek the Almighty first, because from the Almighty comes everything. And if I have to make a decision, and the Almighty is pulling me toward this, if it's the Almighty decision for me to still be with that girlfriend, I'm still gonna have her.
Right.
If it's not the Almighty's way, I'm not gonna have her.
Right.
So I'm not gonna let her way be my way. I just have to just make that decision and let my way be my way.
And pray that she respects that.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah, I love that.
Definitely.
I love that. Okay. You are now working with Rural Area Production, and your manager is Elvis Harton, which tells me now that at least for now, you are focused on a career. Are we now, and I'm getting CDs with new songs. I just got one as it came a while ago with new songs. Are we now looking at an artist who will soon be having a CD out? Are we looking at an artist now that will be on the road performing? What's your future?
Yes. As I said, it's my intention, right? Because now is where I'm at. Now is where I'm at. But my intention is by next year, probably late December, early next year, the album will be out, and accepting, they will see me in the street and stage show and everywhere. So this is Fragrance. So this is my calling, and this is Fragrance now. So people will see Fragrance and know Fragrance,
mm-hmm.
because now is, and they know Fragrance now.
Mm-hmm. I got that. Yes. And you know what is also very interesting too? We're talking about an individual who once wanted to be a soldier. We're talking about a man who actually went into the Jamaica Constabulary Force. And at the same time, we're talking about a man who is God-fearing, cultural, and respectful of people's views. Is there anything that you would like to say to someone who either judges you because you're a police, who judges you because you're a Rastafarian, who judges you for any particular reason? Without knowing you, what would you like to say to that individual?
The only thing Fragrance can say, I have clean hands, pure heart, and to be truthful, there's no one who I can point and say that person is my enemy. Only thing I see is a friendly generation, a friendly set of people. And that's where I'm at. Right now, I can't call a name that me and that person is in malice.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't. That's not within.
Mm-hmm.
That's not within. Mm-hmm. So, only thing, Fragrance is just oneness.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not even going to say love. I'm just going to say oneness.
Right.
Yes.
Know that you have to. Know that you are focused on music. And your mission is talking to every human being that walk the face of the earth. What has it done for your outlook and the breadth and depth of your outlook? Know that you have to speak not just to your cronies, not your cronies, your squaddies, not just to your friends, not just to your family, but no, you have a charge now that you have to relate to the world. What has that done for Fragrance?
It has made Fragrance a stronger individual. A more self-confident individual. It has made Fragrance a signal. Yeah, a signal, you know, so we can't work without signals.
When you say that, what do you mean?
And signals is the vibrational frequency of life.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And when we work and we do it with oneness and all that. So we say waves and we say current. So, you know, everything, all that, it has just made me being electrified.
It is stimulating.
It's current.
Nice.
Yeah, electric. So when people see Fragrance, they just see electric. You know, so at times when I am on meditation with my fellow celestials, you know, I tell them, this is not blood. This time it's flowing in me. It's just electric.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Beautiful. You are clearly a free spirit, clearly an individual who more telepathic than physical.
Definitely.
And that is what to me makes you so beautiful. Is there anything else that you want to say to those listening that we have not touched, anybody that you want to speak about? Just free up.
Only thing I can say to my people, examine yourself. accept others. Doesn't matter what a man do. There is oneness in all of us. If you, as a child, it's two was a child, both of you are Christian. Let me use this phrase. And that child become a thief. Recognize that the energy comes from you rather than putting it on the child. It is coming from you, so that same thief is you. So, acceptance mm-hmm. and live. Mm-hmm. That's fragrance word. Mm-hmm. Accept people.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Beautiful. Well, one thing I can say for sure. When I first met Fragrance, back in the day, as just a songwriter, I have watched you grow leaps and bones.
Definitely.
There are times I look at you and take off my eye right away because I see your spirit. I know spirit is something that you cannot see. I see your spirit. It shines in your face. The other day you came down here and says, Fragrance, oh, you look good looking, sir.
And that's a glow. You say, yeah, glow, sir.
No, because spirit shows.
Yes. And you have to become spirit to see spirits.
It is a myth that yes. It doesn't show. It shows. Whatever you are doing, it is showing, it is glowing, and keep on that track.
Thanks, Mama, and I give thanks.
Yes, I.
Energy, vibration.
Beautiful. So this is a depth of conversation. This is the kind of conversation that I insist that we need as a family. Not one that you have to agree with, not one that you have to embrace. Just something to think about, just something to wrap our brains about, and just enjoy the process of thinking, the process of meditation, remembering that the challenge is an theoretical one. It is not a physical one. Thanks again for coming. Thanks for accepting the invitation.
You're welcome. Energy.
Wonderful to have you in studio.
Thanks.
First in Sav Lamar, what's up, Queen Elise Queen? What an interview with King Fragrance. If I was to mark this interview, I would have given King Fragrance 100%. Queen, listening to this interview, King Fragrance, him sound like a Christian. I talk to him and I never know this side of him. This interview really go deep and wide. I hear things about him that I never know before. Queen, soul to soul, I shot at them. Queen, from the grill, him eyes, I go hard. Now looking back for King Fragrance, him thing loud till it slap over. Don't know. Thanks for the interview, Queen. Thank you very much for listening. We got this one from Richie Innocent in Santa Cruz. Mama King Fragrance exposed a high level of reasoning that challenges limitation in our daily thinking and gives a different perspective. Mama, this is my attraction towards soul to soul because it gives the soul that is being given the moment to speak a free and accepting pathway. King Fragrance flow is like the movements of the wind that intertwine with scent that can attract a himself fragrance, you know. Hey, Mama, your program is one that is way ahead. And we who listen each day are surely blessed to have you engaging us with universal intelligence. King Fragrance, thanks for your informative and intellect input that definitely will inspire a greater relationship with our brothers and sisters. Mama, me no want to come back as a dog. Don't. No, sir. Me can't picture your Richie tie up on a bag. No, sir. Man say me no want to come back as no dog. Hey, I saw Irish studio full of nature. Mama, just take a seat to listen to the ones you interview every Thursday. Intellect family. We have intellect family. We have intellect family. We have intellect.